as well. Find out whether he's seeing that move up on the charts or not. Naresh, hi, morning. Expiry today, but seems like we're in good shape.
Absolutely. So if you look at the shape of Indian markets, we're still trending up slowly. But globally, the markets have been pretty positive across the board. So you've seen a good close on US markets as well. So the structural view is we eventually have the possibility of making a new all-time high on the Nifty as well. All we need is a little bit of a support from some of the heavyweights. We saw yesterday Reliance Industries taking that leadership, but the rest of the names were not. But going forward in April, I would expect three, four heavyweights to make a move. And eventually we cross about 22,600 mark. Also, the Bank Nifty looks very interesting because that's a sector which has underperformed for really long. The risk reward is great for a lot of private banks. So from April, I would expect a dash towards 48,000 on the Bank Nifty and 22,600 on the Nifty.
Taken, and yes, since you're talking about the US markets, it was a very photo finish yesterday from the US markets because the Dow Jones had the best day so far in 2024, a gain of almost 500 points in the Dow Index. Of course, even if you look at S&P 500, managed to close at record high level with a gain of around 0.8%, and the Nasdaq too added almost 0.5%. So the handover has been strong. And do you think, Kunal, this could be one of those triggers as well that the Indian markets are going to see further rally today, because 22,200 has been a bit of a challenging factor for the Nifty?
Well, yeah, good morning, Nisha. So it's been a challenging factor, but I think, you know, we're going into a phase of the markets where the markets are just grappling through what transpired in the first half of the month of March, extreme mid-cap selling, large cap supporting. So now it's completely reversed. Now you have mid-caps reversing, large caps being a lot more, you know, stagnant or, you know, to say in a range for themselves. So I think it's more of a phase of the markets where we're just grappling through the market internals. But the global markets are excellent because, you know, not just the US markets, but you know, even in the, we look at the European markets, the what happens, what's happened to Nikkei as such, and many of the other asset classes and different indices. I think many of these indices are perched at 52-week highs or lifetime highs for themselves. So I think the global setup is quite excellent. It's just that maybe a short-term you know, phase of the market, once that gets over, I think we should get back into a line of outperformance. Would be bullish on the Nifty, and my near-term targets are closer to 20,500 for the index.
Okay, and let's talk stocks. Naresh, what do you think is going to propel the Nifty up today?
So looking more on the rest of the Nifty names, first is the Bayon Tata Steel, clearly a stock which has been testing that breakout points on the 2021 highs, showing relative strength as well, expecting it to catch momentum in the short term. A retest of the breakout done, and now expecting fresh moves to all-time highs. Stop loss now at 148, target price of 170. Second is a Bayon InfoEdge Naukri. Yesterday, the stock finally broke out above that 5,300 mark and very close to a new 52-week high above that 5,500, 5,540. A classical formation of 12 to 18 months of consolidation, then a breakout and a retest of 4,900, 5,000 multiple times. Revising the stop loss now to 5,200 and the target price of 6,000.
Okay, so those are the stock-specific recommendations. Naresh, what about you, Kunal?
I'll go with two buy calls. The first one is around Max Financial Services. Yesterday, the stock came very close towards a key breakout level around 1,010, 1,020 mark for itself. So, would suggest a buy with 1,045 as an immediate target. Stop loss to be kept at 994. And Indian Hotels is something which I've been recommending over the last couple of days. Looks quite strong. The recovery is almost like a V-shaped recovery for Indian Hotels. Looks quite strong even at current levels of 580 plus. So we'll suggest to buy with 608 as a target, stop us at 570.
Okay, let's talk stocks, which are going to...
If you like this video, then like, share and subscribe to ET Now.